So you've decided that you need more than what can be provided by all the variants of Roboto. How do you pick an additional font? Well, it's pretty hard. Choosing the right font isn't only a technical challenge. It's not enough to just pick a font that's easy to read and contrasts well with the content around it. Your choice of font can impact how your users perceive your app and how they emotionally respond to it. Handwritten fonts, or fonts with rounded terminals, can make your app feel informal. On the other hand, very geometric fonts might give an impression of order and structure, and some fonts might even feel robotic. Weight matters too here. Light fonts, or those with really thin serifs, can evoke impressions of elegance, but also impermanence. Meanwhile, ultra bolds might evoke heaviness, but possibly stability. And fonts can even be associated with a time period. While some may have an almost historic significance, others may be considered a little too trendy. There really aren't great absolute rules for choosing the right custom font for your app, but here are a couple of tips that might prove handy. First, limit your font palette. You can often get away with using just one custom font for branding areas like your app bar, and Roboto for everything else. If you do pick another sans serif font to replace Roboto for UI elements like the text here, make sure to switch over completely so you don't have two similar looking fonts next to each other. Here, Helvetica and Roboto are placed next to each other, but since they look kind of similar, it's kind of this weird, you know, uncanny valley. It's not clear if it's intentional or not. Second, try out the font you're thinking of on a couple different devices with varying screen densities. What looks awesome at XX HDPI might look really muddy at MDPI. Notice the serifs on the H are barely even visible. And finally, watch out for unintended cognitive dissonance, and make sure the font fits the mood you're setting in the app. If your product is all about being fast, putting a font with a heavy weight on might give the feeling of a slow, lumbering giant. On the other hand, if you have an app that's highly technical, an overly decorative font might not only be distracting, but it might erode your user's trust in what you're trying to do. So, does your proposed extra custom font meet all those requirements? Great! James is going to walk you through how to use the font you just picked in your app.